data analyst and data scientist. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn from this video? We are going to see what is data analyst, who can become the data analyst, what are the skills required to become data analyst, what are the technologies that we have to learn to become a data analyst. We are even going to see what is meant by a data scientist, who can become the data scientist, what are the skills required to learn in the data scientist, and what are the technologies to explore to learn data scientist, to become a data scientist. So as soon as I talk about the word called data analyst or the data scientist, we might have heard about these terminologies many times nowadays. Earlier, we didn't have these words called data analyst, data scientist, and so on. We used to become Java developer, Python developer, some C language, or some .NET developer, some web developer, and so on. But the market is changing. We are running under Industry 4.1 now, right? So now what's happening in this modern technology? What's happening in this modern world? The skills are getting enhanced. The technologies are getting explored. They are getting advanced. Now, if you have got a job or if you have secured a job as a Java developer, Python developer, web developer, it is the time for you to become a data analyst, data scientist, look towards the higher roles, higher opportunities, higher packages in the organizations. Many people tell that I have come from a degree background, can I become a data analyst? I have completed my graduation, undergraduation in some core departments such as civil, mechanical, electronics, electrical. So can I become a data analyst? Can I become a data scientist? So there are multiple questions that people have in their mindsets. Many people till today, I'm telling you, many people till today, though they are not from a proper background of computers, with some wrong guidance, with some people who they have in their relatives, neighbors, friends, they might have suggested to them to learn full stack Java, to learn full stack Python, then you will get any job. But my dear viewers, always think that if my friend is suggesting for Java, if someone is suggesting for Python, if someone is suggesting for web development, you talk to some fourth person, he or she will suggest you some another technology. You talk to some fifth person, they will suggest you some new technology. So IT is such a field that there are multiple technologies that are emerging in the market. But which are the demanding one, which have the highest possibilities of getting the required job, which has the highest possibility to get a good salary that we are expecting, we need to opt for those kind of technologies. So when I'm talking about a data analyst, many people tell that data analyst is such a kind of course which is not required to have any sort of coding knowledge. Up to 80% this is true. Up to 80% this is true, that without any coding knowledge also you can become a data analyst, but not the complete data analyst. So there is some 10 to 15% of programming knowledge is required for you to become a data analyst completely, to secure a higher job, higher packages, and so on. So let us see what exactly is data analyst and what are the skills that are required to learn this data analyst. So what exactly is data analyst? What are you going to do in this? You are going to gather some information. You are going to transform some data. You are going to clean the data if it is unclean. For what purpose are you transforming it? For what purpose are you cleaning the data? To prepare, to create beautiful reports, to create interactive dashboards, to create very interesting visuals that can help the customer to understand the business and make some decisions from out of it. That's where you use this data analyst part. Now, when I talk about the skills that we should require to become a data analyst are, you should have a knowledge on data visualization, data manipulation, reporting skills. You need to be a good data storyteller. you need to have a statistical analytics. You should also have a skills on analyzing the data. Okay, what is exactly defines about data analyzation? So whichever the data that we receive from the client or customer, 500% sure that that particular data will not be clean. Okay, what is meant by cleaning and uncleaning? Some missing values, some wrong information, wrong data types, okay, many null values. Okay, so these kind of data we will be receiving it when we are working in some projects. So it is required for us to analyze the data and understand what exactly is the data telling us all about. After we understand that, oh, this is about the business. Oh, this data is telling me about this business, how much sales, how much revenue, how much profit, how much cost. So after you understand it, after you analyze the data, then you need to go up with the transformation part by cleaning the data. Okay, so you need to have all these things. But my dear viewers, always understand that you should make a habit of data storytelling. For example, if I have given you one Excel sheet, in that Excel sheet we have some employees information. So now if I show this Excel sheet to a plus 12th grade student, then by looking at the Excel sheet, if they say that, okay, so I have employee ID, employee column, employee department, how much salary they are getting it, and these are the names of them. No, this is not the understanding. Okay, you need to create a story. You need to have a very good skills of data storytelling to explain about the business to your client or customer in a very beautiful way with the help of these visualizations. That's where data analyst will come into the picture. Okay, so now what are the technologies that we have to learn in order to become a data analyst? That I'm going to explain it to you. When I talk to you about the technologies for a data analyst, yes, we need to have any one of the reporting tools, either Power BI or Tableau. But my suggestion is go with the Power BI because it is a bit advanced version of Tableau, but there are many such companies who are also preferring for Tableau. Excel, it is required. Okay, Excel, it is must and should. Okay, and if I talk to you about the database, we need to have SQL Server, which is very much important. And you need to have a knowledge on business insights. For example, as I told you that I have got the data, by just looking at the data, you should not tell me, no one should tell that, okay, so there are four columns, five rows, so this is the information. No, understand the business, what this business is all about. How did they differentiate those categories? On what basis they have differentiated the categories? Why they have mentioned the customer names with only two letters, first two letters? What is the reason? What are the next four digits telling me all about? So we need to make sure that we can understand the business. And one interesting thing which is required is Python. As I told you, without Python, 80%, yes, you are done. But having a basic knowledge on Python related to data transformation part will make you a perfect person to get an excellent job as a data analyst. So these are the technologies that are required for you to become a data analyst. Now, let me make you very clear the difference between the data analyst and the data scientist. Here, who is a data scientist? If I talk about data scientist, is a person who is having a very good statistical and machine learning knowledge, with a very good programming knowledge, with a very good person who can analyze the business and give some predictive results. Okay, so to become a data scientist, you should have a statistical and machine learning skills to deliver some insights that will help the business growth, that will help in the business growth, that helps in business decisions and with the contribution of product development. So when I talk about those data scientists, many people are afraid to become a data scientist nowadays. The reason is that they feel that we need to have a knowledge on Java, C, C++, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, PHP, React.js, okay, AWS, Azure, Microsoft, Power BI, Tableau, SQL Server, MySQL, DBA, Oracle. Until or unless we don't have all these, we cannot become a data scientist. No, please come out of this wrong mindset. You can become a data scientist with just four or five skills. It's very easy. Okay, so what are the skills that we need to have to become a data scientist? That I'm going to explain it to you. Then I will tell you what are the technologies that you need to learn to become a data scientist. So here the skills which are required are data analytics. You need to have the qualitative and quantitative analytics mindset when you are thinking about the data. You need to have a good programming skills, that is 100% in data scientist, but it is not 100% in data analyst. Okay, so data analyst will give you some report preparation dashboards. They will create a reports and help you in decision making about the business. But data scientist will identify what is the problem in the business, how we need to overcome with the problem, what are the statistical methods which are required in order to overcome this problem and get the very good growth in the business. So that's where data scientists will come into the picture. All right. And we need to have a mathematical skills. When I'm talking about mathematical skills, don't think too high mathematical skills. I'm not telling you to become a scientist in mathematics. No. What all the skills that we have learned in our childhood, let me talk about statistics, probability, permutations, combinations. So we have learned this from our fifth standard, right? So those kind of mathematical skills itself, we are going to implement it here as a data scientist. So these are the skills that are required. Now let us see what are the technologies that are required. So the technologies that are required for a data scientist is, when I'm talking about a programming knowledge, my dear viewers, in programming, you learn R language, you learn Python, you learn MATLAB, you are 50% done. Okay, so then yes, then rest of 50% will be having your database, machine learning skills, your analytical skills, your deep learning skills, your visualization, your problem solving skills. All these will come into the picture when you would like to learn or become as a data scientist. Mathematical knowledge is required, statistical knowledge is required, analytical skills is required to understand, identify what is the problem, what kind of formula you would like to implement in order to improve the business and make sure that that doesn't get down. Okay, and when I'm talking about data visualization, a data scientist should also have a knowledge on data visualization. When I'm talking about data visualization, any tool, either Power BI or Tableau, which is required. Why it is required? To make sure that whatever the solution that you have done for the business, that you can represent it in the form of a dashboards, in the form of a report. That's where we go with the data visualization. And yes, when I'm talking about a database, huge data cannot be stored in an Excel sheet or a local folder in a machine. So we obviously go with a database. Any database is fine. Okay, many people go with the MongoDB, many people go with SQL, MySQL. It purely depends upon the company and organization in which you are working in. So these are the technologies that you need to learn to become a data scientist and skills required. So please be very clear, data analyst is completely different with the data scientist. So data scientist is in huge demand, data analyst is in huge demand in the market. Please get the right guidance, take the good platforms to learn these skills so that you can land in your dream job. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.